We're going to dive deep into Claude Cowork in this video, show you a few real use cases of how you can use Claude Cowork, and I'm going to share some tips and tricks along the way that'll help you get the most out of Claude Cowork that you probably haven't seen before. If this is a topic you're interested in, click the link in the description to subscribe to our free AI and vibe coding newsletter. You'll get an update every morning on all of the latest AI and vibe coding news from the previous day. I find it really valuable, and I think you will as well. Let's jump in. The first thing that you need to know about Claude Cowork is that it can work with local files on your computer. What that means is down on the bottom left, you can select a folder on your computer for Claude Cowork to have access to. Not only can it read the files that you're giving it access to, it can also write the files that you give it access to. And that's the key difference, is that it can actually make changes to files that you have. It can create new files, add them to your folders, and work as more of a real coworker inside of your computer file. Just to show you what I mean, inside of this no-code MBA planning folder, there are a lot of different files that Claude Cowork has created for me. So these are files that it's created for me. Now I have a repository that it's going to always have context and reference for different types of strategies, such as a paid ads plan or a newsletter strategy. So now every time I go into Claude Cowork, I can just make sure I'm inside of that folder. Claude will have access to that entire folder. So let's go through some real use cases that you can use Claude Cowork for. So I'm just sending off a message asking Claude to help me plan my day, given what you know my top priorities are. So I'd be happy to help you plan your day. Let me check what's in your folder to understand the priorities. So it read a couple different files inside of that folder. And this is what I mean by how valuable it is to have access to your local files. Something that you should start thinking about is, how can you start getting files onto your computer that then you can feed into Claude? I saw a post on X that I think will resonate and help display this even more. Lenny from Lenny's newsletter, he has 320 podcast transcripts. So he has a folder of all of them. He fed it into Claude, asked it to go through all of the episodes, find important themes, and it did all that work for him. And then I saw he also is sharing the transcripts. If you go to his profile, you could download his transcripts and do what he did, but ask your own questions to Claude. The other thing that's cool about Claude Cowork is it's generally going to ask you clarifying questions before it fully responds to you. And it has this nice UI for doing that. So are there any specific deadlines, meetings, or commitments? Let's say no constraints. So I'm pretty open today. So now it's going to create a plan. Morning block, 2 to 3 hours. Audit your customer list for company emails and see if we can create a Teams page for no-code MBA. Afternoon block, reach out to a couple sponsors about partnerships, or record and publish a YouTube video. And then talks about why it's coming up with these ideas. So right off the bat, I think that's a really cool use case of just using it every morning, going in, planning your day, almost using it like a to-do list. You could actually create a markdown file that is literally just a to-do list that Claude has access to, and then every morning it can go in and give you some ideas of what it could do. It'd be cool if in the future Claude had scheduled tasks so that you could have it do that automatically. I'm sure something like that is coming. It's just a matter of time before they add that type of feature. The other thing that you need to know is on the right side, you can see the context that it's working with. So the folders that it's selected and the working files that it has. Anything that it creates will be an artifact. And then any progress or to-do list that the AI is doing will show up here on the right side. The next use case I'm going to show you is using Claude's Chrome extension inside of Claude Cowork. This is one of the more powerful features that I've discovered here with Claude Cowork, is that it can actually browse and access websites on your behalf. And you can actually watch it happen, which is cool as well. So to show you that use case, I'm going to say, I'd like you to go to the homepage of No-Code MBA and give me feedback on the copy. And you're going to see exactly how this works. So it wants us to log into Claude in Chrome. I'm going to open the settings. I should already be logged in, so that actually shouldn't be an issue. And then hopefully it'll start actually browsing in a second. So it said it had issues. Let me just ask again. I am logged in. Try again. Maybe that's just because I had closed Chrome out. So if Chrome was open, maybe that wouldn't happen. So there we go, now it's working. So again, Cowork is in beta. So it is still going through a few bugs that I've seen. Okay, so now we can see it is on the website. It is literally browsing the website. We can see here because it has that little highlight. And then in Claude, we can see it is basically navigating and using the computer on its own. So now there are more permissions. It is good, I think, that it asks for these types of permissions when it's taking access on your own desktop or on your own browser. So I'm going to say allow. You can read it. So I'm just going to allow all the actions just to make sure that it is going to have access to everything that it needs. Okay, interesting. So it's asking me for every single action. Because I know it's on noco.mba, this isn't a site that I think anything could really go wrong, I'm going to say always allow actions on this site. This is going to allow it to just go through on its own without me having to approve every single action. And as we can see, it closed the pop-up on its own, and now it says, now let me scroll down to see the full page. You can see here it's scrolling down. This is really cool, and there's just so many different use cases that Claude is going to have access to now that you couldn't just do in the chat mode of Claude. This is new to Cowork, giving it the ability to have it all integrated into one platform and having the context of your local file. So just bringing it all together, it's something that I think is going to enable a lot of different use cases. So we got feedback from Claude. It says, I've now seen the full homepage. Let me give you copy feedback. So let's see what it says. So it's saying it could improve the sub headline. I like that improvement, actually. Interesting, the browser tab is outdated. It needs to include AI with it. Yes, that's great. Something that I actually never even thought of to check. Let's see a few other things. Here's what you'll get. Undersells the quantity. Show specific outcomes. No mention of Teams B2B. Yeah, we don't have that yet, but it is something I'd potentially like to try out. Cool. All right, so it gave you some feedback. And what I think is just valuable about Cowork specifically here is that ability for it to browse the internet on its own. And then like one idea that we could do is say, hey, great, like why don't you check out our competitor sites, see if you can come up with any feedback based on what they're doing well for inspiration. There's a lot that we could do here in Claude now that it has access to the internet as well. The next use case I want to show you is how Claude can actually create files for you. So the prompt I just sent is, please create a spreadsheet CRM style I can use to reach out to sponsors. So just, again, giving you an idea of some potential use cases that I could actually create here. What info do you want to track? Basic, detailed, full pipeline, something else. Why don't we say full pipeline? Let's have it do something a little bit more complex. And should I pre-populate it or do a blank template? I'll add 10 to 15 relevant AI no-code companies to get you started. Why don't we have it add pre-populate? So I'm curious what it's going to come up with there as well. So while it's doing that, I want to talk a little bit about skills inside of Claude and how you can use them inside of Cowork and how this is also something really powerful that you should know about if you want to use Cowork. So if we go into capabilities and we go down to skills, so skills are repeatable, customizable instructions that Claude can follow. It's basically just a set of instructions in text that is going to give Claude context about what it can do or what it should do. And then you can also stack skills together. This makes skills different from projects, where a project is just its own contained thing, whereas skills can be used anywhere in any chat. So I have a couple skills that I actually have turned off right now, but we could turn them on to actually see. This was just one I was playing around with for fun. This skill is Old English Copywriting, and you can see, and this is actually a skill that I had Claude create for me. So if you click add, you can create a skill with Claude, tell it what you want to do, and then it'll create a skill in the specific format that it needs. You can also download skills off the internet and upload them as well, so different ones, but this is basically just a skill to use Old English Copywriting. I'm going to turn it on and then show you how we can use this inside of Claude Cowork. Again, this is just one example, not like a particularly useful one, but more of a fun one just to show you what's possible. So we'll jump into that after we see the result of the spreadsheet CRM that Cowork has been creating for us. It's already done. It created the sponsor CRM spreadsheet for us. So we can click that and click allow. So now we can view this CRM that it created, and then we can also download it as well, open it in Numbers, show it in the folder. It looks like it already added it to our folder as well automatically. So we have this now saved in our folder on our computer. and we can preview it here, which is nice, without having to actually open it up in Numbers. So kind of a web-based view, but you can't edit here. It's just a view. To edit, you'd have to ask the AI to make changes. So let's see what it did. It created some prospects. So basically just different AI and no-code platforms. Under contacts, we have basically, I guess this will be a list of any contacts that we have, deals, tracking the deals, and then an activity log for actually tracking what activity we do. Now, I think to take this to the next level, we could, because we have browser use available, we could say, hey, please actually start researching and finding contacts at these companies and go into my Gmail and send emails. This is kind of the next step and is a potential use case. I could see maybe at this point Cowork having a little bit of a challenge with that, but I think that's the way that these tools are going. And this is the trend that I see of these AI platforms basically going from just, well, first of all, being able to do this alone is pretty cool, but then taking that next step and starting to take action on your behalf. And this is something that tools like Manus are doing. There's another tool I've seen called, I think it's called doanything.com, which the agent actually has its own email address so it can reach out. But yeah, in theory, the agent here could take action and start updating this as it does the work. So creating files, another cool use case that I think that you should start thinking about and thinking about how to use this inside of Cowork. Finally, let's jump back into the skills feature I talked about a little bit earlier. And I'm just gonna quickly show you what this means and how it works, and then you can use it for your own use cases. So this actually is a limitation right now of Cowork. I didn't know this until I recorded the video, and I'm sure that this will be something that will be added to Cowork really soon, but I have to actually use the chat feature to include skills. This is a surprise because Claude Code does have the ability to use skills, which is why I'm pretty confident that Cowork is going to include it soon as well. But here we can see it read the copywriting skill. It knew to do that. And I did the exact same prompt. And now it wrote the homepage in a cool old English tone and style. So we go back to Cowork and we go back to that chat and we go to the bottom. When I did that exact same prompt and said, I don't have an old English skill. The skills it does have are Excel, PowerPoint, Word, PDF, visual art, and skill creator, which is interesting. So it does have that skill creator to create skills, but it didn't seem to pick up on the skills that we already had access to in our settings. Again, I think this is going to be fixed. Something else just to note is like these skills are not skills that I created. They're coming by default inside of Claude Cowork. So that's a limitation right now of Claude Cowork, but again, I think it's gonna include the skills pretty soon. If you liked this video, click the link in the description to subscribe to our free AI and vibe coding newsletter. It'll keep you up to date on all of the AI and vibe coding news from the previous day. I find it really valuable. And if you're watching this video, I think you'll find it valuable as well. And subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this. Let me know in the comments what you think of Claude Cowork and how it might compare to other tools you've been seeing. And we'll see you in the next video.